What's up, guys? Nepenthes here, and welcome back to another episode of The Road to Glory. We are starting off today, guys, with some just menu happenings. There's a lot going on in the game right now. Nothing like crazy, oh my god, I'm like well gassed about this kind of menu stuff, but we've got the new team's objective for Ballack, Lampard, or Gerrard. I think I'm going to go with Stevie G. And hope that he wins so that we can get a Stevie G Tifo, because I really like that. And then to start here, we've got the season level 15 player. So we're going to claim the player. I was pretty set on going for the centre-back from La Liga. Just makes the most sense for me, I suppose. But at the same time, I do like all of the options here. I quite like this guy. And, you know, he links to like Cuadrado, James Rodriguez, the Gerard Deulofeu. But I think I'm going to go with this guy. I think he's just a cool card. I think even though we've already got a whole bunch of like crazy defenders, we don't really have that many from La Liga. So it'll be nice to be able to pop him in and use a full La Liga backline should we need to. So we're going to send him into the club and be happy to have him. And then we've got another objective done with Black Friday here, which is win 5, which gives us a draft token pack. Of course, once we finish all of this, we'll get premium gold players pack, 2 mega packs, and another premium gold players pack at the very end. I don't know how long it's going to take me to win 25 games, probably until like Sunday or Monday, but we're going to try and grind through that as well. We've got Rodrigo to start working on. We've got Deulofeu to start working on. We've got the EFL Championships to finish off, and we're 4-0 in champs. Now, the great thing is I don't need to play any more rivals. I played 10 games in rivals and I got to 6,900, which means with the games that we've got left, which is 16, we're going to end up getting enough points to get us to 14,900 on the nose, which is fantastic because that should get us to rank 1, which last week was 14,590, and we finished way, way lower. So for the rest of today, guys, I don't know what we're going to be doing. It's going to be a bit of gameplay, a bit of this, bit of that. God knows what it's going to be. Maybe some SBCs, some flash SBCs if EA put them out. We're still trying to sell off a whole bunch of the content that we've got in the club. We've sold another Sabitzer for 4.5K. You'd love to see it. And I might grind a bit of draft as well. Just see if we can get some 82s and 83s out of the packs as the rewards and sell them off for some big profit. But yeah, for now, guys, I think we're just going to get into some gameplay. All right, guys, welcome back. Now, this week... Well, last week, obviously, we worked really hard to get that Neymar. This week, we are still going to be working hard and selling players where possible. But these flash challenges and stuff, I think we're going to indulge in them this week. We proved a big point last week. As long as we do SBCs that are cost efficient and such, we're going to be in a good spot. So we need a 77 rated squad, which we've got. One club, minimum players 2, minimum from the same league 3. Clubs, minimum 5, 85 chemistry and 11 players in this for a small, rare gold players pack, which is quite nice because it's... basically like half of a 50k pack. And then what I'm going to go through is go and sell all my common golds at 77 plus from like right mid, left mid, right wing, left wing, etc. Now, it's not going to let me open this because we've still got that Joe Gomez, which is sad, but we're going to have to discard him, which is even sadder. And then a small red gold players pack. Give him to me again right here, EA. I'd be happy with that. Let's see what we get. You do get what you get and you don't get upset. It's a board. Let's go. Come on. England. Centre-back. Oh, Colombia. Striker. Obviously, Falcao would have been a record breaker. It's an 83 Zapata. Not quite what you... Oh, I suppose 83s right now are up in price. So are 82s as well. So we'll actually be able to sell him and him for some good coins. And him for some good coins as well. And these guys will just list up and get rid of as well. And I'll be right back. All right, guys. So for a little bit of what we're going to do today, we're going to start with our La Liga 77 squad to work on Rodrigo. I don't know why. I think we'll build a squad for him, play a couple of games, maybe go and build a Serie A squad, start working on Deulofeu, and do a little bit of this, a little bit of that, do a draft, do some foot champs gameplay, a little bit of everything. This is a squad that we're using. We've got Herrerin in goal. We've got DeMarcos at right back, quite nice with the 4-star skill moves. We've got that brand new Aidu in centre back with Koundé. Very good partnership there. And Kone at left back. Good pace. Not other stats. Very good. But we've got Kubo at right mid. And we've got Zubeldia at CDM or centre mid. Marcos Llorente also at centre mid with Oscar Plano, our red card. at left mid. We've got Suarez up front. He's going to get subbed off straight away. And Jean-Felix up there as well. And he's going to get subbed off for this guy right here, Matheus. We need a Brazilian to score with. He's four-star. He's got good pace and really bad balance. But other than that, he's not bad. So let's get our manager in and let's go and start working on this managerial masterpiece. Because that is what this is. This is a managerial masterpiece squad. So let's get into some action and see what we can do. Right, so this guy's doing the La Liga stuff as well. He's got Dembele, Rodrigo, Fati, Suarez, Llorente, Dest, Koundé, and a few others. Oh, let's go. What do I have to score? Finesse goals? Brazilian finesse goals? Let's go. I'm sick at this game, man. Jean-Felix. That's 2-0. Go on. Ooh. He actually biked it. I was about to scream, bike it. Jean-Felix again. Oh, that's a nice finish, that is. That's a nice finish. And this guy's out. He's gone. Yeah, he's gone. He gave me a goal, but we scored two anyway. We won 2-0. We won fair and square out of that one. Against Rossiano, we won fair and square. I mean, we dominated that game. Andy bought on Mbappe, but that's a GG. Red Lozano, Tonali, and Correa again. Red Berardi, terrible backline. And a silver goalkeeper. Well, it was completely miscontrolled. Disappointing. Go on. Go on. Yes, a header, an assist from a four-star, and a goal with the Brazilian. Not today. No, ref, he had about 20 minutes advantage there. It doesn't even matter. Oh, cool. I've tackled Lozano about 7 times during that whole transition there, including the fouls as well. Oh, go on, Jean-Felix. Boom. Things you love to see. He's off. I don't have, that's so sad. That's just so dumb from me. You guys hit me on two counters and two counters only. Well, that second one can't even be considered as a counter. Just silly ball possession given away. What's the point of defending sometimes? Go on in. Right, that's two with the Brazilian. We need one more. Okay. Not at all worrying that, but... That's better. Bang. That's that hat trick with that Brazilian. Let's go. Is this 87 pace? Can they take advantage of the situation? Is the four-star weak foot and the four-star skill moves. Let's go. 5-3. GG's. Can we get another header? Yes, we can. That's two. Let's go. Lozano. Tackles. João Felix. Nice. Well, we're cleaning off some goals and stuff here. Good challenge. Whoa, that is magic. That is a beautiful little finish from the Brazilian. Another assist with the four-star weak foot. 1 minute remaining. No! Oh. He doesn't want to watch his replay now. Hey, GG's. A A very, very strong win there. 8-4. Very, very, very nice. That last goal, the last Brazilian, yeah, so 3-5 for Felix and Matheus. 5 assists for Jean-Felix. Very nice. I think that puts us almost completely on that. This goal here, this one here, this is nice, man. Jean-Felix gets in behind. Lovely little roulette. Through ball in. Oh, look at that. Boom. Ooh, the cleanest little finish over the goalkeeper there. Let's have a look at what that does do for us. The hat-trick hero. 7 out of 8 for the assists. We don't even have to try. 2 out of 13 for the scores. 2 out of 3 for the headers. And 2 out of 7 for the wins. Let's carry on playing on that. And let's see if we can get another easy dub. All right, guys. Welcome back to the Road to Glory. We are back here. EA have added this new silver SBC. I'm going to do him for one reason only, I think. And that is because he's only there for 12 hours. And so the rarity of this SBC is good. And for silver stars, he's going to be brilliant. High-low work rates, 4-star weak foot, super pace, very nice shooting, nice passing, nice dribbling, and very nice physicals as well. 89 stamina on your man. It's a nice SBC. So we're obviously going to use all of our untradeables because we don't have any tradables to put in really now. We've got some traded 84s, but otherwise not a lot. And I'm going to show you guys exactly what we're using. And as I say, he's not necessarily going to get used for all that much. But here you go. So an 82 rated squad with 80 chemistry, 1 German. We've got 83 Dele Alli, of course, untradeable. And we've got 84 Tagliafico, of course, untradeable. 83 Radecki, untradeable. And the rest are just 81s and an 82 Boateng in there, all untradeable. So we're going to send that in. And we're going to get our first record breaker card. We are also very well on our way to Rodrigo. After 4 games, I think 4 games anyway. You're going to come out. There we go. After 4 games or so, we've got most of it done. We're going to open all the packs together at the same time, though. So once I've got the whole setup done, we'll open the packs. So let me show you guys what is here in objectives. What have I got in the store? Oh, yeah, the draft token pack. So we've done the 3 goals. We've done the assists. We've done the 3 headers. We need 10 more goals in games, basically scoring 10 more games and win 4 more games. So we should do the wins before the La Liga lessons, and then we'll open all of it together and get that Rodrigo. So I'll be right back. All right, guys, welcome back to the Road to Glory. EA have released another SBC. It's the 81 plus triple upgrade. It's 11 rare golds for 3 81 pluses. I've got mostly untradeables in here, a couple of tradables. So untradeable Benitez, tradable Antunes, tradable Dendonka, untradeable Perotti, Lala, Otavio, Vanaken, Bakambu, Alcacen, Marega, and Ricardo, all untradeable. And the 3 81 pluses are also untradeable, but you get what you get, don't you? You don't get upset. And I've just got a little, just a little sneaky feeling there could be something quite nice in it for us. We've got draft token pack as well, which of course is very nice. We don't care about that or that. We'll take the draft token and we'll store the position modifier for the time being. Let's see. Kylian Mbappe inbound, am I right? Come on. Come on here, give me the walkout. Give me the walkout. Walkout! Come on! Brazil! Goal kick, no! I already have him! Oh no, mine's tradable, let's go! Let's go, that's massive! What's he worth, like 40k or something? Mine's tradable. Come on, something else nice in here as well. I mean, hey. Oh, you love to see that, don't you? Oh, fantastic. 50k in the bag. Maybe 55k. Yes, EA. Yes. My Alisson can go. Wait, what's he? 178 games, no goals, no assists. You love to see it, boys. Let's go. Alisson gone. Coates gone. Coates, whatever his name is. Acerbi in. That was brilliant for us. Let's go, man. All right, guys, the next Flash SBC is out. This is a fairly expensive one. It requires 8 rares, 80 rated, 95 chemistry with 5 players from the same nation in there as well. We've got a full Spanish squad, untradeable, a tradable Ilaramendi, untradeable Eric Garcia, who has been in a few of our teams, but he can go now. Untradeable Johnny, a tradable Danny Garcia, a tradable Ander Herrera, a tradable Olmo, and a tradable Jonathan Vieira, with an untradable Morata and a tradable Tony Martinez. So half of these are tradable, half of them are untradable for a tradable mega pack. I don't mind that trade-off very much at all. I think that's not a bad trade-off. I think as long as we're looking at picking up somewhere close to like 12, 15K from this pack, we're going to be fine. Our Alisson sold for 53K, which is brilliant. Very, very happy about that. Yeah, we're up to 144K now. And of course, I've got, I'd say about 150K in investments that hopefully will get us back way more than 150K. So we're already looking very nicely to be well over 300K by the end of the day once the investments sell. Here is our mega pack. It's not a walkout, it is a board. Come on, be a big board, be a good card. It's Gulashi. Hey, it's all right, it's an 85. You don't mind an 85 in the slightest, or an 82, actually. Harry Maguire for like 1600 coins. Very nice. An 85 Gulashi coming in at like 8-9K. So yeah, that was definitely worth it for me. That was definitely worth it. We've got Lema. I don't know what he's coming in at. And then the rest of these we'll deal with in a little while. More consumables. That we don't need. That we don't need. Campfall will just list up for whatever. If he sells, he sells. He'll probably go on open bid for like nothing anyway. And the Bundesliga centre-back there for a little bit of coin. So that wasn't too bad at all. Some more consumables that we'll get rid of over time. And I'll see you guys probably for whatever the next objective or whatever is. Who sold their Haps for 650? Lo Celso for 1400. Very nice. Some of these players starting to sell, which is quite nice. I think I sold something else there as well. Willian and Fabian. So I picked up Willian for like all the Premier League rares that I got here were less than 900. Most of them at like 750, 700. So if they sell for like the 1400 min bid that I've got them listed for, brilliant. You know, we're going to make some really, really good coins, which we're already doing, which I'm very happy about. So I'll see you guys in a second. This has got, I feel wrong doing this. 70 rated, 90 chemistry, 10 rares. And one UCL player for a rare gold pack and a gold player pack. It feels wrong. It feels bad. It does not feel good value. It feels like EA are doing their best to clean everybody's club out. And hey, I'm indulging. It's only Black Friday once a year, isn't it? I'm indulging. Why not? You know what I mean? Why on earth not? Let's see what we get. Have I played draft yet? Yeah, unfortunately we lost in a semi-final, my man. We did not have a good draft. And we came up against a good player in the semi-final. All right, let's see what we get. No walkout or boards. Oh, an 82 though. Are they already back down to discard price? Yep. All right, we'll store him in the club for the time being. And then a rare gold pack. When is Cyber Monday? Toby, you can... You all right, pal? Just ask me when Cyber Monday is. Yeah, this is why that's not worth it. What a waste. An absolute waste. That's unfortunate. All right, guys. We have finished Rodrigo. He is done. He is ours. It was a lot of fun, a lot of rage quits, like 1-0 very quick rage quits. This last game, well, the last four games, we didn't need to win the game, so we gave away one win. I mean, this guy stole a win. Look at where our shots are from. I don't know how we didn't beat him. Not that it matters. We only needed the goal to get the Rodrigo, and that was sufficient. And so let us open the packs. We've also got a whole bunch of other packs as well from the Black Friday content. So a mega pack, a 25K pack, and the packs that come with Rodrigo, and a 25K pack from season objectives as well. So here you go, Hattrick Hero for a gold pack. You love to see it. Not really like the most insane pack. 75 plus rated player pack coming in as well. Obviously, these are all untradeable, but hey, if we hit something big out of them, who cares? Scoring in 13 games, and it only took us 13 games as well. For another pack, always nice. Heroic Heading gives us a premium gold pack. Very nice. And then the winning streak gives us an Electrum Players Pack. And of course, as a combined effort, that gives us Record Breaker Rodrigo. So we're also up to 190-ish thousand coins in the bank now as well. I'll show you some of the stuff we've been selling. So there you go, Rodrigo. He is a walkout as well, which is very, very nice. Doesn't really get into any of my teams. Maybe we could use him because we could link him to Talisca and to Allen and to Neymar. So, you know, that whole Brazilian theme. He is four-star. He's got nice dribbling, good stamina, and good pace. His positioning is quite nice as well. His passing and shooting is a little bit meh. So maybe a dead eye on him. Maybe he could be usable. You know, obviously, he could be a lot of fun. And then the other objectives we've got here is the Black Friday win 10, which gives us a premium gold players pack. And win 15, which gives us a mega pack. And I think we're at 19 wins altogether now. Of course, when we win, we're 18. There you go. So when we win 25, we'll get another 25k pack. And another mega pack. So that will probably be for tomorrow's video. But what have we sold? So we sold some bronzes and silvers, most likely. Gulashi went. And then, yeah, some silvers for quite low and a little bronze there as well. And I've got still a tray pile full of stuff. Like, I honestly think by time, even just right now, if I just sell what I've got, even at like current market price on my transfer list and my watch list, I genuinely think we'll be up at about 400,000 coins, which is just crazy. How quickly we've accelerated through the coins again, which is really, really nice. So here we go. Some of these packs, gold pack to start, of course, gives us some players for future SBCs and some consumables. I don't anticipate we're going to get anything at all here. Maybe the mega pack will be nice to us. Of course, it'll be nice to get something. Ooh, 75 to 80 rated player pick. Always nice. And we shall take a first owner, Fredericks. He's going to be super useful. Center forwards cam card and a few other little bits and bobs. And then one player that will get us some coins back. So not bad for a 5k pack there. Then a 7.5k pack. What do we get out of this? It is a rare gold player. Not a walkout. It's not a board. It's not a blue. So therefore, it's not going to be anything super useful. 82s would be very nice right now, though. It's not going to be 82s. And a whole bunch of, again, just a lot of nothing that we don't care about. And we get one player that we can list up there. Very nice for Visa. And we'll just take the 30 coins for the badge there. That leaves us with a small Electrum Players pack. Now, only one rare and three gold. So I don't really expect to have anything. Oh, it is a rare gold. It's not a walkout. It's not a board. It's not a blue either. Hey, it's a rare gold rather than the rare silver. That's not too bad. Thuram, Adrian, and a whole bunch of other players. No dupes there, which is super nice. And then an Electrum Players pack. Now, this is one rare and one gold, six gold. So it's a rare gold again. It's a board. Very nice. Très bien. French. Cam is Fekir. Could you imagine if it was Mendy, guys? That would have been phenomenal. But that is not bad. A nice 83 Fekir is very good. We can pop him in and then we get some back from these common golds here that have some value. Very nice indeed. And Horgan as well. I remember Horgan's like player of the year card, was it? About 3 or 4 years ago. That was a really good card, wasn't it? And then a 75 plus rated rare pack. Come on here, man. Give me something big. Not a board. It's unlucky. What do we got? Oh, it's an 82 though. I don't mind it. I don't mind the 82s. And then a rare gold pack. This is from the season object. The seasons. Whatever the thing is. No boards, no blues, so nothing out of this. Maybe like a 5k coin unlock would be quite nice. Nope. Another Mesut Ozil, I think, is untradeable. Yeah, I think. Oh no, Wesley's tradable, I believe. Yeah. So Wesley will try and get rid of for a little bit extra. And then the stadium theme will this untradeable as well. So Mesut Ozil unfortunately has to go. Then a premium gold players pack. Can it actually be a premium gold players pack? No, it can't. It doesn't have a board in it. It does have a Mason Mount and a Paredes. It has a Nick Pope. Mine is tradable. He is worth absolutely nothing. Which is sad. And then another couple of commons that we can get rid of and get a few coins back for. And then last but not least, guys, a mega pack. You know the rules. Can it be a mega pack? Come on, EA, man. No, it can't. It's not even boards. So we got one board and it was out of an Electrum Players pack from all of that. That's pretty sad. I won't even lie. That is pretty sad. We get a Hunter Chemstar, which is all right, I suppose. We get a Richarlison, who's already untradeable. A Stindl that we literally just packed. And a Crivelli. It's also untradeable. We've got the Roma badge. That's also untradeable. The lime green stadium theme. Also untradeable. And the green fireworks. Also untradeable. So all of those packs. And nothing to show back. That is sad. But the journey continues, guys. We do now have Rodrigo in our squad. Next up, we're going to be working towards Delafeu, which I'm really happy about, and some more champs games. All right, guys, welcome back, my dudes. We're going to have a bit more gameplay today because I haven't put any champs games or anything in, but I think this is going to be quite a long episode because I've done a lot of the SBCs and stuff. But before we get into what's next, or maybe this will be the end of the video, I don't know. I just want to grab a couple of comments from the Friday night video. The first one is from Matty G. He says, if you've got Neymar, why are you saving for Mbappe? You can only play one player who isn't first owner at a time, or is the rule changing? And basically, I think I'm going to change. I think I'm just going to move away from the first owner Road to Glory. Not to the point where I necessarily go out and buy anyone and everyone. But for big players, I just want them. You know what I mean? Like, we could actually just swap out Talisca for Mbappe and then perfect chem still everywhere. The reason why, I suppose, is because whilst I would, in an ideal world, I wouldn't have to go away from first owner. And some of that comes down to my mentality when playing FIFA and just accepting a lower standard of competitiveness. And a lot of that comes from me just actually wanting to enjoy FIFA and play with the best players. And so some of that also comes from the fact that, like, if we could put together a full French League squad by now or a full Premier League squad by now of really cool players, we'd be fine. But of course we can't, right? Because, you know, we've got a good right back. We've got Koscielny. We don't have a left back. We don't have a quality striker. We don't have a quality CDM, although we've got a quality midfielder. So we're missing so many areas. So I don't necessarily want to go away from first owner Road to Glory in the sense of, you know, the idea is still going to be to complete SBCs that are cool, to pack players and so on and so forth. But I also would like to have a Road to Glory where come team of the year, I could just buy whoever I want, play the hell out of them and still have a good time, you know. So I haven't decided on it 100% yet. And I'm open to listen to your guys' viewpoint on it. But yeah, the idea, I suppose, right now is absolutely that we'll be picking up when we can a Neymar, an Mbappe and a Cristiano Ronaldo. And then when big players come out, or maybe some icons, some of them as well. And I can't tell you guys, excuse me for yawning. My God, my bad. Can't tell you guys how incredible this guy has been. 13 goals in 12 games with 9 assists. He's just magic. He's just amazing. I love him a lot. And this guy as well. 12 goals and 10 assists in 14 games from Cam. Anderson Talisca is obviously doing well. I actually really like Talisca as well. I like him as our centre mid. So yeah, that's that kind of wrapped up and answered. We then had a couple of comments about making coins, which I'm going to get to at the end. We had one comment from Sebster who said, my opponent had 1996 skill rating, the same as me. I'm embarrassed that I lost that. Where's the logic? So just so you know, I had to explain this last year, the year before and the year before. Sometimes what goes on in my brain and what translates out of my mouth aren't always in sync. Have you ever said something to someone and thought something and just assumed that they know what you're thinking about, right? So when I talk, I remember the game that you were referring to. I think I lost by 2 goals. I wasn't saying I'm embarrassed for losing that because he had the same skill rating as me. I came out of that game and I was just like, I played really good. I let myself down, poor defending. That's where I'm embarrassed. I lost that game. I shouldn't have lost that game. It's almost like a complete separate instance to the fact that he had the same skill rating as me. Looking at the same skill rating and being like, oh, he's got the same skill rating as me. That's like one entity. Then I'm really embarrassed that I lost that game is a completely other entity. And even then, being embarrassed to lose a game of FIFA, probably a bit extreme. But, you know, when you play FIFA, when you're in that heat at the moment, it could get, you could just say and do some crazy things, you know? And then in terms of making coins, guys, so we're already up to 191,000 coins. I went and bought Inform Carrasco because I think he was very cheap. He was like 30K. And there's potential that there'll be a João Felix man of the match, right? So yeah, I went and bought Carrasco there for 30,750 coins. God knows what he's selling for right now. Certainly no more than 32 or 33,000, I'm sure. But of course, there's been a mass amount of him put onto the market. The fact that he's from Atletico Madrid is obviously a big dub because he'll strong link to a João Felix player of the month should he get one. The fact that he's La Liga, and if you need an inform, means he might even be usable in the SBC. So either way, we've got him there. So it's like two comments that I'm going to read at once and then kind of answer them both together. But, and we've obviously already been through this, and a lot of you guys that watch every video will know. But the first one is from Philip. He says, Nep, did you gain coins by investing or just selling your club? I don't really understand. Neymar would be handy for everyone. Please let me know. And Abraham says, wow, how did Nep do a base icon pack and afford Neymar in 1 week? LMAO, loving the content. And then there's a subsequent reply to that that says he's manipulating the market through Footbin Solutions. He's been doing it for years. Only way for him to generate that amount of coins in such a quick time period. So first of all, let me just tell you guys, I absolutely do not manipulate the market using Footbin Solutions. I know people do. I absolutely know how to do it. But at 6 p.m., when you can manipulate the market through Footbin Solutions, I'm live streaming. I'm making content. I'm like, if every day, you know, on my streams at 6:15, I was like, oh, hold on, guys, I'm going to be back in half an hour. I'll see you soon. You probably have some cause to say something stupid like that. You don't need to manipulate the market on Footbin. You could just read and understand and interpret the market, right? And that's what we've done this week. But in terms of how I was able to do the base icon pack and afford Neymar, of course, as a few people kind of mentioned in the comments, we already had a whole bunch of stuff in the club from just playing the game, right? And that is where I think a lot of people kind of miss everything. The fact that just through playing the game, it's enough. I did a little bit of investing last week. We spent about 250K. No, we bought about 200 and... Yeah, maybe like 200K in centre-backs from the La Liga. I sold them for a grand total of about 400K, maybe 500K. So that's where I made about 200,000-300,000 coins profit. The rest of it came from... Once again, if we just go and look at the club and look at... ignore the... Obviously, the starting lineup. If we just look at what's in the club in terms of non-loan cards... We have got Jordi Alba, Jamie Vardy, Hakim Ziyech, Milinkovic Savic. We've got Clement Longley, the informed Carrasco, Jose Calleon, and Ben Yedder. I think Ben Yedder's tradable as well, which we packed him out of draft. I don't think he's worth much, but I could easily get another 10-15K there. Should I want him? But we're saving him for when we're probably going to end up needing him from an objective if we stay first owner, of course. And so... The club stocks up really, really quickly. And there's a couple of ways the club stocks up really, really quickly. First of all, bronze pack method. Fine. Second of all, rewards. Obviously, I don't really get squad battles rewards anymore, but weekend league and rivals rewards fills up the club. Thirdly, is the SBCs like the marquee matchups. Now, we've done a few SBCs here today that I probably shouldn't have done. We just didn't make coins or whatever on them. Obviously, one of the SBCs that we've done, we packed that Alisson. The untradeable Alisson. So we got to sell our tradable Alisson for 53K. That's where a big chunk of the coins came from today. But I think one of the big things that a lot of people really, really misinterpret that I do a lot, where I get a lot of club stocking from, is the draft. I mean, we have won the draft 18 times from 42 entries. We've got a very good record and almost like 5-1 win-loss ratio in draft. Like today, for example, I lost in the semi-final of the draft and I got a 25K pack and a 15K pack. So for a 15,000 coin outlay, I got two packs where I packed an 85 rated Gulashi out of one of those packs. And he sold for like 8K. And then a few other little players here and there and all the consumables. And that's another area of this game where it's so easy to make coins, and that's the consumables aspect. And we're, again, our consumables are just stacking up and stacking up and stacking up because we're selling and investing in players right now. And so when I made that long video talking about how I could make from my account loads of coins, like obviously ignore the cam to center forward and center forward to cams, because I don't even know if they'll ever rise, right? Other than that, we don't have too many position modifiers. A few strikers, center forward to strikers. Everything else, there's a couple here or there of. But for chem styles, we've got a couple of engines, couple of anchors, couple of hawks that I invested in, fair few finishers and snipers, and then a whole bunch of dead eyes that I picked up for like 400 coins each. Now, I've been selling those off to lazy buyers for 900 to 1,000 coins. Obviously, it takes time. It's boring. It's a process that people just can't be bothered to do. And so where I might make 100,000 coins off of these over the course of the next 2 weeks as I sell them off, somebody else wouldn't. And so that's 100,000 coins you didn't have because I put the time in. But one of the other big misconceptions that a lot of people think is that I spend a lot of time on this game, a lot of time playing draft, playing rivals, playing champs, doing objectives. Like objectives, for example, look at all of the packs that we opened today from those objectives that we've completed. Let's just look at what's there, right? We've already opened a draft token pack, a premium gold players pack, a mega pack. We're going to get another mega pack and another premium gold players pack. We've already opened, or we're going to open a prime electrum players pack. We've already opened a gold pack, a 75 plus pack, a small electrum pack, a premium gold pack, and an electrum players pack. We've already opened two rare gold player packs and 75 plus players from the Hector Bellerin objectives. I don't think Silver Stars had any packs there. And anything else that's gone. In terms of season progress, of course, we're nearly at the rare gold pack here, but we've already opened a rare gold pack, a small prime gold players pack, a 75 plus rare player pack, a gold players pack, and a jumbo gold 26 pack. So, and then a 75 plus pack and a 75 plus pack. So it's so easy to, like, even though they're untradeable, but that's what we put into the tradable SBCs. And I think there's a tradable SBC there now that I just looked at and I didn't want to do. I don't know if it's there now. It was a 80 rated midfielder. But one of the biggest, yeah, see, 80 rated rare player. It's just terrible, man. It's there for another 24 minutes, 25 minutes or whatever. It's a full gold squad. You're basically trading in 11 golds, one of them being rare, for one gold midfielder. And that is just shocking value, right? So I'm not going to do that. Instead, I should be selling the commons that I've got, but I'm being lazy there. So, I mean, I've been streaming all day, but we talked about it before, and it's very hard for me to show you guys in every episode exactly everything that I do. But as a prime example, I'll show you right now, because this is going to be the last time that I go in with these, and I did it for Black Friday, and hopefully it still pays off tomorrow. But I went and bought about 150 Premier League players, rare golds, on open bid, and I got them for anywhere between 650 and 900. So we've got, what have we got? These are all first owner. Oh, they're all the 82s I'm selling, but yeah, all of these guys here, 750, 950, 650, 750, 1,000 for a John Stones, 900, 650, 900. Now, all it takes is EA to release an SBC and these guys go up in price, but I've already sold about 20 or 30 of them for, I've listed them all up for 1.3 to 3.4K. None of them have actually gone up to that price, but I've sold 30 or 40 of them between 1.3 and 3.4K to just lazy buyers, people that don't know what the prices are or accidentally buy something or something like that. So every time one goes for 1.3K, we make 3 to 700 coins. If it goes for 3.4K, we make an extra 2,000 coins on top. So I've got all those Premier League players there. And then in the transfer targets here, I've got 75 more, right? You can see them all here. Like some of them I accidentally bid on myself for over 1,000, but like we get 80 rated Romero for 650 coins. I can't lose on him, right? I could just discard him and get the coins back if I wanted. We get a Pepe for 950 coins. In fact, he might even be worth picking up and having a look at his price right now. No, he's only 1,100 coins still. And that's a great price, right? But so I went in on 150 of these Premier League players because I'm pretty certain that eventually I'm going to be able to sell them on for a fairly good price, right? And if I can't, I'm not going to lose much on them. I'm going to make more on the trade-off, right? So that's like, basically, there's no one grand thing that I do that just generates millions and millions of coins or anything. It's playing every little aspect of the game to the best of my ability. Grinding drafts because I know I can get far in the drafts and get good value packs for my time. Grinding bronze packs because it's really worth it. Doing small trading here and there with consumables or low budget players. Playing the living hell out of every aspect of the game. And one of the biggest things that we did last week that didn't make us any coins but saved us so many coins was just avoiding doing SBCs that we just didn't need. And when we look at the team here, this Atal SBC, I mean, he's an all right card, right? Let's just, what was he? He was like 15K, I think. I can't remember exactly how much his SBC was, but I believe it was 30K. So that's 30K on there. That's just pointless. I didn't have to do it. This Iñaki Williams was like 150K or something. We didn't need to do it, right? Yes, we've used him a little bit, but we didn't need to do it. We've got Laurent Koscielny. Man, I wish I didn't do him. I know I've got him for the Arsenal past and present, but that was 100,000 coins down the drain. We've got Kramaric, who, again, I wish I didn't do. That was 50,000 coins down the drain. We got Thiago Silva. I don't think I've played. It's even got one game on him. Not a single game for Thiago Silva. Now, I know he was cheap. He was one of the first SBCs. He was 11K. And maybe 86 rates are worth more than 11K. So maybe that wasn't so bad in the grand scheme of things. Bellarabi was a waste of coins. Calvert-Lewin was a waste of coins. I don't know about some of these other guys here. Matuidi was probably a waste of coins. 10K that didn't need to do. Tonali as well. 10K that didn't need to do. And of course, I've got all these informs right now as well, guys. Like that, mostly a tradable. I think there's a couple of untradables. Like if you take into consideration all the coins I've wasted on SBCs, for example, the old me, the me of last year, would have looked at Sergio Aguero, and I probably would have done him. And I would have got rid of some players here and there, and I would have been like, guys, look how cool this Aguero is. Four star. I like this Aguero a lot. He looks great. His dribbling's really nice. His shooting's good, and his pace is good. With a Hunter Kem style or a Hawk Kem style, he becomes a superb player. But his price right now is coming in at 470,000 coins. Do you know how many gold players are more expensive than him? There's like three of them. Now, of course, he's not a gold player. And of course, there are lots of icons and stuff in the game as well. But you've got Lionel Messi at five. There's literally four players worth more than this Aguero card. Messi, Neymar, Mbappe, and Ronaldo. Instead of getting this Sergio Aguero, who's, yeah, he's pretty cool at four star, high medium, 88 pace, 85 shooting. You know, you can go and buy Sadio Mane on Xbox for 280K and on PlayStation for 350K. And he has six more pace, the same dribbling, two more physical, five more passing and the same shooting, and has four star as well. So the old me would have just done this and then had 500,000 coins just in an SBC card that I can't do anything other than play with. The new me, I would much rather go get the Rodrigo that we've already got, work towards the Deulofeu that we're already working towards, get those EFL players and stuff. Like, guys, we are like officially like 7 weeks into this game, right? And the amount of objective players we've already picked up is insane. Think of where we will be by time Team of the Year comes around in another 7 or 8 weeks, right? Think how many more cool cards we would have just played for. So I want to like, I just want to make sure I play the game as much as possible with the cards that we've got, and then just save coins, because coins are king, man. Like, you can always go on the market, buy someone, play with them and sell them. Of course, I have no intention of selling Neymar right now, but should something incredible happen and come along where it's like, okay, we need 1 million coins real quick, I can sell Neymar. Now we'll have 1.2 million coins, right? For example, R9 is here. Now, his baby card is only four star, right? Yeah, the 90 rated. It's 2.7 million coins. That's a lot of bloody coins, don't get me wrong. But a finisher on that R9, and he's a ridiculously good card, right? But he's four star. But how cool would it be to play with R9, right? So, like, by putting all of my coins into non-first owner but tradable cards, we always have the opportunity afterwards to sell them. If we look at team of the year cards from last year, I want you guys to join me on this journey. This definitely will be the end of the video because I've gone on for far too long, right? If we look at team of the year players from last year, right? Team of the year, Cristiano Ronaldo. Let's have a look. Now, obviously, we're a ways away from team of the year, but at the same time, I've still got time to make more money for team of the year. Now, I don't know what Mane started at, or De Jong started at, or De Bruyne started at. I think he was about 2 million. Forget the defenders. But let's look at Sadio Mane's team of the year last year. He started at 3.2-ish, very quickly dropped down to 2.6, and then 2.2 within like 2 weeks, right? So let's say after team of the year comes out, we wait 2 weeks, maybe 1 week, 10 days, something like that, right? And then we go and start buying team of the year attackers. I've already got 1 million in Neymar. Now, of course, Neymar, let's have a look at Neymar last year, this time versus now, versus this time then, so to speak, right? Is this his card from last year? No, this is this year, isn't it? I need to go here. We need to go and find wherever the biggest Neymar is. We need to go to this one. By the end of the year, he was 100K. At this time last year, where are we? November the 28th. Guess what? He was about 1,074,000. He was about the same price as what he is right now, to the day, right? By the time Team of the Year come out in January, he was about 700 to 750K, which means based on last year's market, and it will be different, but based on last year's market, we will have about 700 to 800K just sitting in Neymar. So when Team of the Year comes and we want to go and buy a player, like De Jong comes out at 1.7 million. Man, look at these crashes. You know, De Bruyne came out at like 3 million. We're already a good way to them. But if I put those coins into Sergio Aguero instead, an untradeable Sergio Aguero, or, you know, people were like, not begging me, but really, 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 really trying to like get me to do Player of the Month Heung-min Son. Oh, Nep, you like Son? You've got Son? Do his Player of the Month, man. It's a good upgrade for your team. 700K for an untradeable that we can't get back. Lewandowski is the same. People are like, oh, do that like for a 93 rated card, man. 320K. For a 93 rated card that we just, I won't get enjoyment out of, you know? So by just not doing SBCs, by just saving those coins, it allows us to make more coins, to have more coins, to invest in players like a Neymar or an Mbappe or a Kante or, you know, just another big player. Like, I would absolutely love to have a weekend league where we play with the rule breakers, Di Maria. He's only 363K. I think with a dead eye on him, I think he would be a joy to play with. Five-star skill moves, good Stam. Well, all right, Stam. Brilliant shooting, good pace. I've used him in draft a couple of times and I've loved him. I would love to play a weekend league with him, you know? And so now I can because I could just go and buy that 363K card and then go and sell it afterwards. Instead of doing, as an example, Bellarabi. I don't know if it has the price here for him. It doesn't, but instead of doing like this Bellarabi for whatever he was, 120, 150K or whatever, and then being like, well, I can't get that back now. If I just didn't do Bellarabi and I didn't do Inaki Williams, I could just buy Di Maria instead and then sell him afterwards, you know? So that's where we're at with that. So I just wanted to kind of address that with you guys, I suppose. If you want to see me do it, if you want to see me making the coins, just come and watch me on Facebook, guys. fb.gg/Nepenthes. The link is down below and you'll see everything. Obviously, today we made a whole bunch of coins because we packed Alisson. We sold loads of bronzes and silvers. Played the drafts and made some good coins off of the drafts. We've sold some of the Premier League investments. We've been playing the account well again. And somebody had actually said in the comment section, oh, he doesn't make that many coins, guys. He just sells his club. He just sells the things that he's got in his club. But you have to remember that I didn't start my account with all of these things in my club already. That is a culmination of all the work we've been putting in for the account. It's absolutely viable for you guys to do it as well. You know, if you've got a small budget, start with bronze packs and go from there. if you've got a bit of a bigger budget, investing and using that unassigned investment pile glitch that I talked about before is a good way to do it. But yeah, that's where we're at. But anyway, that is going to be the end of the video for today, because this is going to be a super, super long one. But thank you guys for watching. Hopefully you enjoyed it, and I'll see you next time. I'm out. Peace.